to you. Hope is stirring, hearts are yearning for you. We long for you, 'cause when we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away. Washed away. Hosanna, Hosanna, you are the God who saves us, worthy of all our praises. Hosanna, Hosanna, come on. Washed away. Hosanna, Hosanna, you are the God who saves us, worthy of all our praises. Hosanna, Hosanna, come everywhere.
Give thanks to the Lord. We will tell everyone we meet what God has done. Let us bring praise to the name of the Lord. We will honor God's holy name with shouts of joy. Be mindful of all that God provides for us. We will remember the world of wonders God has made.
When we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away. Washed away. Hosanna, Hosanna,
Well, good morning to everyone joining together today as we share music from classic to contemporary, spoken word from puppets through preachers, and viewers from near and from far. I'm Steve Warner, and on behalf of Matthew Allard and myself, the music leaders at St. Andrews and Own Sound, and all our other contributors, we want to welcome you to our Sunday morning live stream and trust it will be a time of refreshing and contemplation for each of you. Before we go any further, we have a quick good news update from Brian.
Hi, everyone. Good morning. I have a quick update for you this morning, and this one is a good news update from the Board of Managers, who wish to announce that we have a new custodian in place now, and she will be starting work tomorrow. This was a very important step towards getting back into the building, and we are very happy to have Lily McTeer join us starting tomorrow. It's been a long road, and we still have more steps to do, but this is a very important step, and we welcome her to our church family. Enjoy the service.
Thanks, Brian, for that update. That's good news both for the people of St. Andrews and the building of St. Andrews and that facility that we get to enjoy. Now we're going to head to our first hymn from the choir today. This is a well-known hymn, but it's equally well-known with two different tunes. The choir is going to sing it for us with one of those tunes, from which I will pick up on the piano, with the other tune these lyrics are often paired with. During that instrumental, I'm going to put on the screen a prayer that we can say together today.
How firm a foundation, ye saints of the Lord, is laid for your faith in God's excellent word. What more can God say than to you hath been said? To you that for refuge to Jesus have fled. Fear not, I am with thee, oh, be not dismayed, for I am thy God and will still give thee aid. I'll strengthen thee, help thee, and cause thee to stand, upheld by my righteous, omnipotent hand. When through the deep waters I call thee to go, the rivers of woe shall not thee overflow. For I will be with thee, thy troubles to bless, and sanctify to thee thy deepest distress. When through fiery trials thy pathway shall lie, my grace all sufficient shall be thy supply. The flame shall not hurt thee, I only design thy dross to consume and thy gold to refine. The soul that on Jesus hath leaned for repose, I will not desert to his foes. That soul, though all hell should endeavor to shake, I'll never, no, never, no, never forsake.
I hope you picked up on the thematic connection between those hymn lyrics and the prayer text. Now we have a visit from our new guest who began to pop in for a furry and friendly visit a few weeks ago. Yes, Andy is here, I hope, to share a thought with our kids today. Kids of all ages. Speaking of kids, just a reminder that we now have a Sam's Kids playlist on our YouTube channel. And not including today's visit from Andy, there are already 10 videos there of songs and Andy visits from over the past few months. And we're actually approaching 30 videos in the main Sam's playlist, which is, as you remember, a collection of single musical items from our live stream since we began over 4 months ago. Anyways, Andy, are you there? Come say hello.
Andy, playing your instrument and praising God? God loves to hear us praise Him. In our Bible, in Psalm 150, it says, "Praise the Lord, praise God in His sanctuary, praise Him in His mighty heavens, praise Him for His acts of power, praise Him for His surpassing greatness, praise Him with the sound of trumpet, praise Him with the harp and lyre, praise Him with the timbrel and dancing. Praise Him with the strings and pipe. Praise Him with the clash of cymbals. Praise Him with resounding cymbals. Let everyone and everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord." So let's use our voices and instruments that we have or that we've made to praise God. Bye.
So that scripture that Andy and Sharon shared with us reminded me of a song I know, but I've never yet used during my time at St. Andrews. It's called "Let Everything That Has Breath," and it was written by Matt Redmond about 20 years ago. You may know it already. It has a simple chorus that goes like this.
Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord.
Pretty easy, eh? We got it. So let's do it again. And this time I'm going to throw in a verse, which is a bit more wordy. See if you can keep up with it. Praise you in the morning, praise you in the evening, praise you when I'm young and when I'm old. Praise you when I'm laughing, praise you when I'm grieving, praise you in every season of the soul. If we could see how much you're worth, your power, your mind, your endless love, then surely we would never cease. Everything that hath breath, praise the Lord. Praise you in the morning, praise you in the evening, Praise you, I'm young and Whittemore. Praise you, and I'm laughing. Praise you, and I'm grieving. Praise you every season of the soul. If we could see how much you're worth, your power, your might, your endless love, then surely we would never cease to praise. But everything that hath breath, praise the Lord. 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 Thanks for singing along. Doug is going to share with us our scripture for today, followed by a hymn from the choir which needs no introduction, and then our message for today from Reverend Chuck Moon.
Our scripture reading this morning is Matthew 14, 22 to 33, reading from the New International Version. Jesus walks on the water. Immediately, Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go ahead of him onto the other side, while he dismissed the crowd. After he had dismissed them, he went up on a mountainside by himself to pray. Later that night, he was there alone, and the boat was already a considerable distance from land, buffeted by the waves because the wind was against it. Shortly before dawn, Jesus went out to them, walking on the lake. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. "It's a ghost," they said, and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage, it is I, don't be afraid." "Lord, if it is you," Peter replied, "tell me to come to you on the water." "Come," he said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came toward Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid and began to sink, cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith," he said, "why did you doubt?" When they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Then those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God."
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not thy compassions. Thou hast been, thou forever will.
3 weeks ago, Sunday, July 19th, there was a power outage after a few hours of heavy rain and wind. My place was without power about 7 hours. My kids just kept asking, "When are we going to have internet back?" Just like when you're going on a field trip, "Are we there yet?" So our family decided to go out and walk on the shoreline. It was more like my wife and I decided to go out, dragging our kid out from our place. It was a windy afternoon. Usually a very busy, crowded shoreline was empty, quiet, unattended. You could hardly see anyone on the beach. After a few minutes of walk, we noticed there were two people playing a large kite, a power kite. For those of you who are wondering what a power kite looks like, here's the picture. We could see they were having so much fun on this rainy, windy day. They made me realize not everyone will stay home on a stormy day. There are those who will come out and play because it is a rainy, windy, stormy day. Today we are going to meditate the story of Jesus walking on the water on a rainy, windy day. Jesus playing on water during a rainy, windy, stormy day. I'm going to read the story from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 14, verses from 20 to 33. Immediately, Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go on ahead of him to the other side, while he dismissed the crowd. After he had dismissed them, he went up on a mountainside by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone, but the boat was already a considerable distance from land, buffeted by the waves because the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, Jesus went out to them, walking on the lake. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. "It's a ghost," they said, cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage. It is I. Don't be afraid." "Lord, if it is you," Peter replied, "tell me to come to you on the water." "Come," he said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, came toward Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid, beginning to sink, cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. "You of little faith," he said, "why did you doubt?" And when they climbed into the boat, the wind died down. Then those who were in the boat worshipped him, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." I think it is very important for us to remember, even Jesus faced many stormy days in his life journey. It wasn't always sunny and nice for Jesus. Just like all of us, Jesus too faced many storms and challenges in his life. The difference is that Jesus walks and plays on water, and we often get sunk by the same water. This is how the King David prayed to God when he faced the great challenge, a storm, in his life. Psalm 69. Rescue me from the mire. Do not let me sink. Deliver me from those who hate me, from the deep waters. Do not let the flood waters engulf me, or depth swallow me up, or the pit close its mouth over me. Answer me, Lord, out of the goodness of your love. In your great mercy, turn to me. Do not hide your face from your servant. Answer me quickly, for I am in trouble. I believe all of us can relate to this prayer written by David. Do not let me sink. Because we know exactly what it is like to sink. How heavy our life can become. How we can be buried and sunk by our own responsibility and our commitment, our work, our family, friends, relationship, conflict, brokenness, sickness, health, failure. Sometimes we get sunk by our own feeling of unworthiness, frustration in ourselves and frustration with others. Anger, disappointment, misunderstanding, and unending worries. The good news is that when we sink, Jesus will come to us. I'd like to read the verse 30 and 31. When Peter saw the wind, he was afraid, beginning to sink, cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus reached out his hand and caught him. That's what Jesus does when we sink. He will come and offer his hand to us immediately. The Gospel of Matthew promises with us that God will come to us. Jesus will come to us and invite us to walk on the water with him. That we don't need to stay under the water forever. That we can come out and walk on the water with our Lord Jesus Christ. Just like Jesus invited Peter by saying, "Come," even in this very moment, he is inviting us. That when we face stormy days in our own life journey, that we are invited to find God. And God desires to be found by us. Whether we walk on the water, whether we swim, whether we sail on a boat, is not relevant. But what matters to us, what matters to God, is that we come to God. That we come to Jesus Christ, the source of our life, the source of our hope and our strength and our courage. We come to God. We come to God to find strength. To walk on the water is to recognize the voice of Jesus Christ in our heart, telling us what to do. To walk on the water with our Lord Jesus Christ is about whether we recognize this particular voice of Jesus Christ for us. Take courage. It is I. Don't be afraid. To walk on the water is to remember that our Lord Jesus Christ is with us in this very moment. That is to hear God telling us everything will be okay. This too will pass. We cannot explain where this voice comes from, how everything is going to be okay. But somehow we know it's going to be okay. We know even if it does not go the way we plan, we want, we know it's going to be okay because somehow we know God is in charge of our human life. I believe this is what it means to walk on the water. Romans chapter 4 verse 18, against all hope, Abraham in hope believed. To hope against all hope. To hope against all the reasons we cannot be hopeful. I believe that's what it means to walk on the water with our Lord Jesus Christ. An American writer, Margaret Whitley, shares the story of her trip to Robben Island, a UNESCO World Heritage Site. This island is famous for its prison, where Mr. Nelson Mandela and many others were incarcerated for their pursuit and fight for freedom and equality. The tour group stood in a long, narrow room that had been used as a prison cell for dozens of freedom fighters. Picture yourself in a space, crowded, cramped, and barren. The prisoners lived without cots or furniture, cement floors for bed. The only light entered through slender windows near the ceiling. The tour group listened to the guy's narration. "I was a prisoner in this very room," he tells them. The gravity his words mingles with the cold, sipping up through the floor, and there is a chill. The group stares through prison bars, surveys the lifeless cell, tries to imagine suffering from relentless threats and capricious brutality. The guide pauses, as if remembering, gazing the length of his former cell, speaking quietly, almost a whisper. He says, "Sometimes, to pass the time here, we taught each other ballroom dancing." If these prisoners could transform their prison into a dancing floor, we can sure walk, dance, play on the water. Yes, our life can be hard. People can be even more challenging than our life. But we humans are much stronger than our life can be. Because God lives in us. Because the Spirit of our Lord Jesus Christ empowers our human spirit. Dear friends, may God empower our spirit. May God help us to play and dance and sing and walk on the water. May we not sink, but may we come and reach out to the hand of our Lord Jesus Christ. May we remember that God is with us in this very moment. May God bless you, give you courage and strength. Amen.
Standing on this mountaintop, looking just how far we've come, knowing that for every step you were with. with us, kneeling on this battleground, seeing just how much you've done, knowing every victory was your power in us. Scars and struggles on the way, but with joy our hearts can say, yes, our hearts can say. Never once did we ever walk alone. Never once did you leave us on our own. You are faithful, God, you are faithful. You are faithful. Top, looking just how far we've gone, knowing that for every step you were with us, kneeling on this battleground, seeing just how much you've done, knowing every victory was your power in us. Scars and struggles on the way, joy our hearts can say, yes, our hearts can say. Never once did we ever walk alone. Never once did you leave us on our own. You are faithful, God, you are faithful. You are faithful, God, you are faithful. Scars and struggles on the way, but with joy our hearts can say, never once did we ever walk alone. Carried by your constant grace, held within your perfect peace. Never once, no, we never walked alone. Never once did we ever walk alone. Never once did you leave us on our own. You are faithful, God.
Well, thanks, Chuck, for those words today. And thanks to all of our contributors, musically or spoken, for helping bring life to this weekly stream. It's been a few weeks since we used our benediction song, Go Now in Peace. So I'd like to close our time with that song today. And I'm going to use a slideshow that I used a couple months ago of beautiful nature pics that Marilyn has taken and shared with us. It's a great reminder of the beauty and the love that surrounds us each and every day. And may you know and feel that during this coming week.
Go now in peace, never be afraid.